Hello everyone, what's happening? This is Forgo, and today we have November Sneak Peek 1. I was really hoping I would see something else, but we'll get to talk about that in a second. So, greetings agents, this is CM Fragment of Marvel Future Fight. In the darkness after Civil War, the former villain Norman Osborn played an integral role in fending off a secret invasion. It has been confirmed that he is in contact with Loki and is now assembling a new team for unknown purposes. We will reveal the members of this team as we get more information, but for now it looks like the Green Goblin is no more, and I believe that is a pretty big hit that Green Goblin is going to be getting a new uniform. Who is Norman Osborn? And what uniform is it? The new armored leader, and this pretty much kind of gives it away as to what it is. Let's check this out. So as you all just saw, that was the Iron Patriot. And you saw the little acronym there that said Hammer, which if I remember correctly, it's an organization that was developed. I don't really know a lot about the Dark Avengers. Will be able to exert leadership to rival Iron Man and Captain America, huh? I don't know about all that. There's nobody like Captain America and Iron Man. We will soon announce other members of the team once we acquire info. Thank you. Now let's go down here and we got to see what's going on here. So already I'm seeing more dislikes than likes. This is to be expected, especially due to the boycott and the fact that we're getting a sneak peek, and yes, we're getting Iron Patriot. And what this means more than likely is, you know, because they did bring up the fact that they're going to the Dark Avengers, right? So who are the Dark Avengers? Well, there's a bunch of different characters that's actually been the Dark Avengers. I mean, there's Moonstone, there's Ares, there's the Navar, who is Marvel Boy with Captain Marvel, aka Captain Marvel. Those are some of the main ones. And then there's Sentry. We'll talk a little bit more about those characters in a second, but I'm just curious what we're getting. So Sentry we are getting. Yep. I mean, that's exciting. It's exciting that we're getting Sentry. Sentry, yeah, it looks like a lot of people are going to be really happy. I mean, Sentry is like insanely powerful dude. This is a guy that fought one-on-one against World War Hulk in the World War Hulk storyline. Ryan Reynolds, you know, is pretty much an immortal. He can only die if he wants to die. I mean, in fact, in the comics, he pretty well laid dormant in the sun until he just wanted to return. I mean, he's so stupid. Phasing powers, matter manipulation, all kinds of crazy crap. Really, he should be a native tier 2, to be perfectly honest. He is way overpowered. And here you see a picture of him. He's a dope dude. We've all really been asking for him for a long time. However, you know, due to the current situation in the game, it's like, I'm excited for this, right? I'm excited for the Dark Avengers. I'm excited that Norman Osborn, who's a complete trash character in this game, Green Goblin's trash, could actually, you know, could be getting a nice upgrade. And that's awesome. That is awesome. Now, just imagine if he got a tier 3 and was better than Iron Man. I think that would probably upset a lot of people. I wouldn't like it. I have no problem with Iron Patriot, but come on, man. Norman stole that armor from Tony Stark. Iron Man is the brains of the outfit. He really should be the most powerful. And for a lot of other reasons as well. Sentry is a villain. Yep. Sentry Red Gobby is coming. Yep. I really don't know a lot about the Dark Avengers storyline. Just a little bit about some of the characters. So a real boycott means we refuse to do anything, not just one thing. Yeah. See, and this is the thing. I really wish they would have put something in here that was addressing the boycott issues, because, I mean, Black Friday is just around the corner. I mean, we are talking extremely soon. In 6 days, Black Friday starts, and we're going to be getting announcements before then. And I really, you know, personally, guys, I want to be able to put money in this game. I really want to support it. And, you know, for me, and I know a lot of other players on Black Friday, we like to stock up on materials. You know, we know that maybe the tier 3 tickets are going to be coming, and just all transcendent tickets, all kinds of crazy crap. And I would have loved to have gotten a couple of extra tier threes, like Storm, and you know, well, Scarlet, she's a native tier two, probably couldn't do her. But I really would have loved to have done that, and I think a lot of other people would too. And if the boycott's going on, well, then a lot of us aren't. And the thing is, that's really going to put a sour taste in our mouths if the boycott's going on during Black Friday. Because if it is, then we're all going to carry this resentment towards Netmarble, like even more so than what we already have afterwards. Because we're all going to be like, man, if those bastards would have just listened to us and they would have just acknowledged us and let us know they were going to, you know, address these or fix these problems in the game with the cars and the CTPs, we could have been able to spend money on Black Friday, got some materials that we wanted, stocked up for the year like a lot of us plan to every year. But no, because they were so stubborn and bullheaded and just decided not to tell us anything until after Black Friday. And, you know, it's really a lose-lose for everybody in this situation. You know, if Netmarble would just listen and address all these issues, then we would spend money on Black Friday and they make money. We get what we want. We get to stockpile. But if this boycott is still going on, which I really don't want it to be, but if it is, it is. You know, what can we do? What can we do? You know, they want to be stubborn. That's their choice. You know, but they're going to lose money doing it. Be honest, expect Red Goblin Uni for Norman Osborn. Man, that would have been dope. That'd have been dope. Seriously, guys, this would have been dope. This would have been dope. YouTube says it's December update, by the way. Well, you know, they can do whatever they want, but the boycott still stands strong. Yeah, see, this is what, you know, increase daily crystals, the Shadowlands shop, that would be awesome. Improve ABX rewards, something we've been crying for months and months and months and months and months. And see, this is what it is. And it's just, I really would have preferred them just to say something. But let's talk about the characters that could potentially be coming into the game. So, you know, some of the characters that I think could probably be coming in is Moonstone. And Moonstone is just a, you know, she's a really, I can't even remember her actual name. Forgive me for that, but she's a really powerful character. She can actually phase, super strong, super fast, power of flight, all kinds of goodies. She can shoot lasers. She's kind of like a Captain Marvel in a way, except she can phase. Really powerful character on par with being able to fight the Hulk and so on and so on. And then you have Ares, who a lot of you might be familiar with from Greek mythology, you know, the god of war. Only second to Hercules and Zeus as far as his actual physical strength, tactical genius. He could be in the game. I think he'd just be a combat type. I think Moonstone would probably be a blast type. And then Navar, Captain Marvel, you know, Marvel Boy, that's his other AKA. You know, really strong, you know, Captain Marvel powers, blah, blah, blah. I don't know a lot about them, so I don't want to go into too much detail. And there could be others. There are other characters that were part of the Dark Avengers. And then Sentry, who is, I mean, I think that's the one that most of us would be most excited for. But really, he should be a native tier two. And if they're going to make a character like Doctor Doom, if they're going to make a character like Doctor Doom a damn universal, then Sentry should be a universal. But they probably won't. They'll probably make Sentry a blast type or some retarded crap. They could make him a combat. That is possible. Don't see his speed happening at all. I don't see that happening at all. But I really think, you know, probably combat, but universal would be the way to go. Even though he is a human, but guess what? So is this guy. This never did really make any sense, although I liked it at the time. It really never made any sense to me when Gladiator's a damn combat. I mean, an alien from space is combat, but a human is universal. Netmarble's logic. So, I'm excited for the new uniform. You know, I mean, it's really going to be nice to see Green Goblin get a massive upgrade. Well, he's not going to be Green Goblin anymore, but to be Iron Patriot. And that would be fantastic. And I really do think that he's going to be just getting a uniform. And that's awesome. It's always good to see old characters get stronger. We definitely want to see that. And, you know, so we know we could be getting new characters like Ares and Moonstone, Sentry, maybe the other Captain Marvel, and who knows who else might come. But here's the thing, if they're paywalls, guess what? Most people aren't going to buy them. So, Net Marvel, I really, really would advise you to address the CTP and card issues. I really would. Do it before Black Friday, man. Do not wait until after Black Friday, because if you do that, the player base is going to have a hell of a lot of resentment towards you, even more so than now, because we were not able to buy anything that we wanted to buy due to the boycott, because we got to make sure that you hear us out and give in to our demands, because if you're not going to, well, then you're just going to pay the price, which means you're not going to be making any money during Black Friday. So it's a lose-lose if the boycott's still going on during Black Friday. And it's a win-win if Netmarble would, like, get off their butts and address these issues. And it's a little dev note saying, hey, we're going to give us blah, blah resources. We're going to do this for you. We're going to do this for you. But they haven't done it yet. So it's kind of one of the things right now where it's hard to be excited for this sneak peek. I'm happy, you know, about the characters and everything that we could be getting, the potential. There's a lot of potential there. Let me know what you all think about it. Let me know if you're excited and how you feel about it. And unity in the community, we all remain strong together. And I hope you enjoyed the video. Thank you for watching. Y'all take care and have a good one.